Welcome to the class, students. We were discussing about phylum Annelida in the previous class, so we will continue it. Phylum Annelida. As you can see in this figure, these all annelids are aquatic or terrestrial, bilateral symmetry. That means by only one plane, they can be divided into two equal halves, right? That's why they are named as bilateral symmetry. Segmented with organ system level of organization. As you can see the figure clearly, many segments, these type of segments, the lines are there in each figure. You can see in each type of organism, these type of lines are there. That means their body is divided into different segments. And they are having the advanced level of organization, that is organ system level of organization. They are aquatic, that lived in water. And annelids like Nereus possess lateral appendages or parapodia for swimming. They are having the, on the lateral sides, they are having the small feet-like structures which help them for swimming. Nephridia help in osmoregulation and excretion. In the previous one, they are having the flame cells for the osmoregulation and excretion. They are having nephridia. Osmoregulation means for maintaining the level of water and minerals in the body, that means osmotic conditions of the body. Okay, the neural system consists of paired ganglia connected by lateral nerves to a double ventral nerve cord. Okay, they are dioecious, that means two organisms are required for the process of reproduction. That means these are the unisexual one. Unisexual means either they will be the male or either female. Only one sex will be there. Okay. But some are monoecious too. Monoecious means one organism is required for the process of reproduction. That means both male and female are present in a single organism. And these type of organism is also named as bisexual. Okay. Examples are Ferritema, that is earthworm, Hirudinaria, that is blood-sucking leech. These are the examples of Annelida. Okay. The next phylum is named as Arthropoda. Arthro means jointed, poda means legs. That means the organism which are having the jointed legs. As you can see in the figure, they all are having the jointed legs. As you can see in this one, this is the one part. After that, this is the second part of the leg. Okay, then this is the third part of the leg. So one part, second part and the third one. That means one leg is formed of three joints. Okay, two joints are there and the three parts which constitute the one leg. As you can see in all these, a large variety of specimens, a large variety of organisms comes under the Arthropoda. Arthropoda is the richest one in the case of diversity. This is the phylum which includes the maximum number of species. Okay. As I said, the large phylum of animals which include insects, because all the insects are having the jointed legs. Okay. They are having organ system of level of organization, that is the advanced level. They are triploblastic. Triploblastic means they are having the three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm and endoderm. Okay. With chitinous endoskeleton, that means their structure, the internal skeleton, okay, which is having the outer coating of chitin. Chitin is a substance which get deposited on its surface, which is present in the outer surface. So that's why their skeleton is named as chitinous exoskeleton. Okay, the body consists of head, thorax and abdomen. Their body is divided into the three parts, head, thorax and abdomen region. They are having the jointed legs, as you can see in the figure. Respiratory organs are gills, book lungs or tracheal system. These things are there for the process of respiration. And they are having the open circulatory system. What do you mean by open circulatory system? The system which is not having the blood vessels for the transport of blood. That means arteries, veins and capillaries are not there. Okay. Excretion occurs through Malpighian tubules and sense organs like antenna or eyes are present. Fertilization is internal, that means both male and female fused inside, and mostly oviparous, that means they lay eggs. That's all about the Arthropoda. What is the importance like bombyx, silkworm, which form the silk, which is very costlier one. Okay. Vectors, anopheles, AIDS, culex, these are the vectors which transmit the disease from the infected person to the healthy person. These are not the causative agent. Actually, causative agents are those which cause diseases, and vectors are those which transmit the disease from the infected to the healthy one. So these are the vectors. And one living fossil is also there that is named as Lamulus, and the common name is king crab. Okay. The next phylum, or the last phylum for today's classes, that is Mollusca. These are terrestrial, as you can see in the figure, or aquatic organ level of organization. They are also having the bilateral symmetry, as you can see, by only one plane. They can be divided into two equal halves. They are have the triploblastic, having the three germ layers, ectoderm, mesoderm, and endoderm. They are coelomate, that means having the true body cavity. That means these are the eucoelomates. Okay. Body is divided into head, muscular foot, and the visceral hump. Head portion, just look at the figure carefully. This is the head portion, and this last one is the muscular foot by which they will move, and these one, this a hump like structure, as a muscular in nature, that's why muscular hump. These are unsegmented, as you can see there is no segments, and covered with calcareous shell. For example, in this organism, this shell is there. These are the shelled organism, or you can also see this one. The organism is present inside them, and these shells are made up of calcium. So calcareous shells are there. They are having feather-like gills are present between the hump and mantle. Mantle ki jo outer layer hoti hai, and hump this shell-like structure, the hard covering. And mantle is the outer skin of the organism which lives inside them. So feather-like gills are present between them. माउथ कंटेन फाइल लाइक रास्पिंग ऑर्गन. इनका जो माउथ होता है उनके ऊपर रास्पिंग, जो उनको एंगल्फ कर लेते हैं एकदम फीडिंग को, दैट रास्पिंग लाइक स्ट्रक्चर इज नेम्ड एज रैडुला. एंड द एग्जाम्पल ऑफ दिस फाइलम इज पाइला एंड ऑक्टोपस. दैट्स ऑल अबाउट टुडेज क्लास. इन द नेक्स्ट क्लास वी विल स्टडी अबाउट द अदर फाइलम्स ऑफ एनिमेलिया किंगडम.